Let me tell you all a story about the base Guantanamo. And the admiral who runs it, he's a man you'd like to know. In December 1963, he came down on a ship, and he wasn't even wearing any big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was February 64 when Castro got confused, and he stopped the base's water by closing off the tubes. Oh, he made his move in panic, so he made one little slip. He forgot about the admiral with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. They are stealing Cuban water, shouted Castro with a lie. So the admiral had them cut the pipe, they found that it was dry. Now the pipe is cut, the ends are sealed, it doesn't even drip. And the man who had them do it had a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Every morning at the northeast gate, the Marines were standing by. They were ready there for anything that anyone might try. And they knew that they'd have action if they had a little slip, 'cause the admiral stood on Bulkley's Hill with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. All the leathernecks weren't worried about a bit of Cuban might. For 180 years, Marines have been the first to fight. And they knew if they were marching out to take a little trip, they'd be following an admiral with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Big iron, big iron. They'd be following an admiral with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Let me tell a story about Guantanamo and the cool Marine who made illegal H2O. When they sealed the pipe and cut the water flow to nil, he got a load of copper and he built himself a still. In the early morning and the nighttime too, you could hear him driving down on Sherman Avenue. He stole a CB tank truck, the muffler did corrode. It made so darn much noise, they called the highway Thunder Road. And there was thunder, thunder, over Thunder Road. Thunder was his muffler, and water was his load. H2O to quench the people's thirst. He'd sell the stuff to anyone but women and children first. He made his deliveries almost every day. You could brush your teeth while he'd fill up your ice cube tray. If you had to wash, he was nice to have around. He'd sell you all you needed, only 90 cents a pound. He hit all the restaurants all around the base. It sure kept him busy selling water every place. But when he hit the chief's club, they said, get out of here. We're conserving water, 'cause we're drinking only beer. And there was thunder, thunder, over Thunder Road. Thunder was his muffler, and water was his load. H2O for anyone to drink. It cost you only 40 cents to make your glasses clink. On the 1st of April, 1964, the base police said, Leatherneck, don't make your run no more. We've got our patrolmen covering the base. We've got the helicopter up, you can't hide any place. Still, he brought his tanker roaring down the road, taking quarters on two wheels with his illegal load. He left the road at 40 as fast as he could go. And when they found his body, man, he reeked of H2O. And there was thunder, thunder, over Thunder Road. Thunder was his muffler and water was his load. He had swallowed so much H2O, he had to go to hell.